Okay, for adding a scarf on the on an animated object, so you load the animated alembic and you prepare everything. So as you may see, I changed the timeline from, so the timeline by default is like this, right? I changed the timeline to mine, like just some space, some time, like 20 frames or 24 frames, because it's 24 frames per second, like 1 second or 2 seconds, depending on what you want. Maybe 2 seconds would be better, but I leave it as 1 second. So the animation starts from one. So it's just like for 1 second, it just does nothing. So you import the scarf, you position it to where it must be with transform nodes. So it was there, but like then it's been positioned here. So if we merge these two, we see that, you know, everything is in place in the mesh nodes. I would like to add a bit of color just for separation. This is not rendering color, this is just a visualization color. So just for visualization purposes, brown okay. So what we need is to turn the cloth, the scarf into cloth, which is easy. Just search for cloth and configure vellum cloth on scarf. So it's a vellum cloth with some attributes, which we get there. And then you want this cloth to fall, right? So, and this cloth, right from the beginning, you can tell that this is the object that. So if you look at the first input, says collision geometry, you can say that this is the object that the collision happens on it. This is this bear. You add a solver, which is the brain to run the simulation, attach it here. That could go from here to here. So and the solver, so if I run this, things should fall. So like let's say I run it, you see that starts falling. On the surface of the bear, it's so stretchy, it goes inside the body, it's not thick enough in terms of simulation. So how we manage that? So you see that it's like there are issues here, it's like geometry intersection, this is like called geometry intersection problem, which happened here and some other places. So we have to make the cloth thicker. So if you look at the cloth here, it has, when I click on it, it has a thickness which says calculate uniform. I say that calculate set uniform, which like visualizes the cloth. So you can turn the visualization. This is the thickness of your cloth that you can vary it, make it thicker. So you see that like the thickness of the cloth is much more now. Also, I possibly want this cloth to not fall on from some points, like let's say the knot here or around the ears or like in on top of the hair. I want them to be pinned. So here you have pin points for the animation, which I press Control Spacebar 4 to see it from side. I grab select point and click on this. You can paint select for more accurate, but I just, for the sake of speed, I click on here. I click on the lasso. I select a bunch of points where I think hold shift, they should not slide down and move. Maybe around here. maybe around here. Well, maybe this one slightly specify one or two or three. Yeah, three. Spacebar three. For this one, I hold shift and just the knot. We want these to like to do like beautiful movement. And once you select this, once your cursor is inside the scene, you just press enter. So you see those points added. Our cloth was so stretchy, so I make it stiffer, like 20 times stiffer. It was so bendy, we make it 20 times less bendy. Oh, you know, these are the numbers that you have to start work with. All this dragging, actually I can add more dragging as well. Let's go back to our bear. Let's turn off the points. Earlier, okay. Let's run the simulation again. So this 24 frames at the beginning, or like 48 frames for you. It's better to have it 2 seconds. It just gives the simulation to run before the animation begins. So you want the animation to begin when the cloth is settled. Possibly our animation begins when the cloth is not set. Oh, this is too still is too stretchy, but let it run. I let the story go with.
Because it's like bouncing back up.
Oh, it's bouncing back up. Okay, let me pause. So, like what when we run the simulation, you see that it just bounces back. Tries to settle, but our animation starts too early, so we have to give. Then we see there are issues with like these movements on the surface. This could be the result of a very thick cloth. Like you see that like there is maybe we have to make it even thicker. Also, like this is a double layer cloth. Like, you know, maybe we have to make it one layer instead of double layer geometry. So one layer geometry could do a better job. But then also we have vellum post-processing, which does a bit of help in that kind of some layering out the issues. You see that these are the issues, these are like kind of blurred out. You can even do more blurring. Oh, that's very much a lot. And D in the angle, what does it mean? Oh no, we don't need that. Thickening it, oh, of course we want thickening it. Oh, that's too thick. Maybe just 10% thickening it could be. Be useful. So a bit of post-processing doesn't hurt. I possibly turn. Oh no, that helps. Okay, and then So possibly I should have pinned when I go to my pinned areas. So you see that these areas are pinned. I can hold shift and add more to it. I possibly have to like select everything around the ears because that was the, so I told them that, okay, you know what, there should be no simulation on that. They should be like pinned. And I press enter. So you see, this is the beauty of proceduralism. So things can be procedurally adjusted. So I let you to adjust every detail, but once everything is done and you're happy, caching is the most important thing. So you definitely have to file cache everything. Is there any vellum cache? No, just simple caching would do the job. So your project belongs to a, your file belongs to a project folder. So you can set the project, the project is set here. So like your caching goes here. So if I click on the job, so I can create a new project. Project path would be on here. And
I think it's inside one of the folders.
Oh, it's, you already created the project?
Oh no, I mean like where this is, it's in, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So I, oh, sorry. I call this ice cream. What shot it is? Ice cream shot. Shot sim. So you see that these are the folders of the project. So once I create the project, Control Shift S to save it there. So I have, you have to save it to the job, which is here.
Yeah.
Ice cream sim. So then I'm sure that my sim goes to the sim or geo.
Okay.
Depending on. No.
Okay.
Next time you have to go and set the project to ice cream. Oh, where was it?
I think it's on Houdini projects.
Oh yeah. So you have to set it here, and then like, you know, it just gets set there. Actually, I have to set project in here, and then it's ready. So when you want to cache it, you don't want to cache it with all these attributes.
Yeah.
You want to cache it with as minimum attributes as possible. Or you can cache it with everything you want, and then when you drop Alembic it, which means exporting it as Alembic back to Maya.
Yeah. Why would we export it back to Maya?
If you need.
Oh, okay.
If you need.
Yeah.
If you don't, and you want to just render it here.
Yeah.
So if you like, so okay, that's a good question. So that's why I just keep it Alembic here. That's why I clean up. So I say, delete. At delete, which means attribute delete.
Mm-hmm.
So before that, we say okay, everything ****. Everything goes away. So you see that all that information, extra information, is point attributes is gone. We possibly should have kept the UV. Okay, so you see that vertex attribute, which is UV, I keep it.
Okay.
So you see that UV is there, but point attributes, we don't, I don't need like these like detailed point attributes. I just want point.
Mm-hmm.
But primitive attributes are not needed. You might need to, if you assign material before, I suggest you assign material after.
Okay.
Then you see that it keeps the, kind of primitive materials. You can delete groups as well, because the groups are not needed anymore. So I can say group delete here. So and *. So now we have a very clean kind of data set. You just make sure that this one goes as a bgo.sc into your heap folder. Which?
Will this only export out the scalp or the bear as well?
No, only scalp.
Okay.
It doesn't export, it caches.
Right. Yeah.
Caching means that it generates a hard drive file of your simulation.
Yeah.
So your simulation, so let's cache a few frames. I'll show you what I mean by that. So let's go, it has to go here, which already is. Let's say, let me just hold shift and actually, no, it's control shift and click. So let's set up, let's say 20 frames, right? And here I would say 20 frames. So we just, I run this simulation for 20 frames with the caching. I have to save to disk. Actually, when I press save to disk, it runs the simulation and caches all together.
Okay.
Let me pause a little bit. Okay, so it is cached. So now you see, this is the beauty of the cache. That so if I don't cache it, for every single frame, it has to reprocess it again and again and again, right?
Yeah.
But once cached, you can disconnect this and you can tell that load from cache.
Yeah.
So what happens is that your simulation is there and it just like plays smoothly and nicely. So without you being dependent to the simulation tree. Okay. So once, so you see that it has a sign of the computer, it leads from the computer, not from the simulation tree. If this is not your desired simulation, you go delete the cache, you basically just delete this node, and then you re-cache it.
Okay.
So that's the pipeline for a piece of cloth on a body. If you do render here, you just like connect this cache to the merge and just carry on with your rendering processes.
Yeah.
If you have to send it back to Maya, here, Rob Alembic, adjust where do you want, like set where do you want to save it and just press save to this.
Okay.